Welcome to USA Breaking News Today. Please subscribe and click notification box to get all breaking news alert. Breaking news today. Iran US crisis, Tehran hits back at Washington over demands military withdrawal from Syria. Iran has lashed out at the US following Rex Tillerson's remarks Tehran's military need to withdraw from Syria and suggested American forces are the ones who need to leave instead. Speaking in Jordan today, the U.S. Secretary of State said Iran and Iran-backed forces should withdraw from the war-torn nation over concerns from Washington about a recent confrontation between Tehran and Israel. However, his comments were quickly met with condemnation by a senior Iranian official who said the forces were legitimate and at the invitation of Syria. Ali Akbar Velayati, a top aide to Iran's supreme leader, said, "Iran's military presence in Syria was based on invitation of the Syrian government. Those should leave Syria who are there without the permission of the Syrian legal government." The reaction was in response to U.S. forces saying they were attacked by pro-Assad Syrian soldiers. The Syrian forces of President Bashar al-Assad have in the past been assisted by Iranian-backed militias and Russian forces. Iran's involvement in Syria includes the deployment of Iran-backed forces near the Israeli-occupied Golan Heights, which has alarmed Tel Aviv. Israel also has accused Iran of planning to build precision-guided missile factories in Lebanon, which is home to the powerful Hezbollah movement, one of the groups fighting in support of Assad in Syria. Over the weekend, an Israeli F-16 was gunned down as it returned from a bombing raid on Iran-backed positions in Syria early on Saturday, an official in Damascus said. Syrian Assistant Foreign Minister Mansoussan on Tuesday said, "Have full confidence the aggressor will be greatly surprised because it thought this war of attrition Syria has been exposed to for years, had made it incapable of confronting attacks. God willing, they will see more surprises whenever they try to attack Syria." Following the attack, Israel hit back saying that it would respond to every provocation. Israeli Defense Minister Avigdor Lieberman said, "There are no limitations on military operations, and nor do we accept any limitations. We will respond to every provocation. We will continue to defend our vital security and other interests. And I would like to paraphrase the well-known saying, this is not the time to bark, this is the time to bite." Israeli Prime Minister Benjamin Netanyahu also said Israeli forces would press ahead with Syria operations despite their loss of the advanced warplane, the first it has lost to enemy fire in 36 years. Thanks for watch. Please subscribe channel for latest news.